Welcome to my YouTube channel. I hope you guys are doing great and you guys are staying safe and, you know, do what you gotta do. Practice social distancing. Y'all better be practicing. Remember to wash those hands. You know, if you can't wash it right away, always have hand sanitizer on. And I still believe that when you wash your hands, wash your face as well. Don't put the hand sanitizer, obviously. Because I feel like if you go outside, your face pick up on stuff as well. So that's my theory. When you wash those hands, wash your face. So, and also before we start this video, I want to give a big shout out to all of the healthcares out there and also all of those essential workers that are working super hard on our behalf to so we can have food, so we can have water, so we can have everything. So we are very thankful for them because, you know, some of them have families, or well, most of them, whether you 18, 19, you have mom and dad or whatnot. So I'm thankful that they are willing to risk their lives to make sure that we have food, water, and stuff like that. So thank you guys. We appreciate you. And if there's a way we can help, please send me a link below and so I can help the best way I can. And I want to give a special shout out to my family, my aunt and my godmother who are nurses, and my cousins, and also my best friends, and some of my good friends. I see you guys. Y'all rock. Y'all really rock. Anyway, I've tried to shoot this video all day long. Seriously, not all afternoon long. But now I feel like it's the perfect time. Anyway, so I don't really believe in like exposing yourself too much about your private life. But I thought this video was like, something that friends and people who watch me and just, you know, just to share. Because I feel like we all go through things, and sometimes by someone sharing their story, it can help the other. So the thing is, I'm like, what, 26? And I was talking to my college roommate, and we were playing a game. Like, my friend have, like, one of them, Misha, she have, like, she bought those cards that have questions that you can ask each other, just, you know, to help. I think it's just great. It helps conversations going and to keep conversation going and stuff. So on her stack, I can't remember what game it was, but her stack, one of the questions was, what are you insecure about? And, you know, when she asked me and Liza, I was ready. What do you think? The question is like, what do you think I'm insecure about? Meaning like she's asking us about her and vice versa. So that's how it's gonna go. So I was like, yes, yes, yes. Boom, this is what I think. Boom, this is what I think. And she was like, oh, you're ready, you're ready. I was like, yeah. And then I'm waiting. When she was like, oh, she's like, I have one for you. And she said, you're insecure about love. I was like, excuse me. And I was like, am I? Oh, no, I don't think so. And then the light bulb went in my head, I think. And I would end up agreeing with them. And Liza second Misha. She was like, yeah, you always talk about when you're dating and stuff like that, but at the same time, you don't go for it. You like very close off. You like very guarded. You just, there's something that keeps stopping you to be fully in love and stuff like that. And like, or accept it or be like fully your full self. And I was like, well, no, I don't think so. Because, and I, at first I was like, nah, and then it dawned on me that's so true, because I came up to the reason why I've been insecure about love. It's because of my size. I'm very comfortable in who I am as a person. I love me. I have no problem with how I am and stuff like that. But I do think, not comfortable with how people see me when it comes to my size. Personality wise, I think I rock. I think I'm a very beautiful girl. I think I'm very smart. I think very positive of me. But I do think I can't, like, it just, like, you know, I do think when it comes to my size, I just, like, even putting it into words seems difficult. And then when we were talking about it, I kind of, like, cried a little bit because they were so right. And I was like, I never talk about this with people, but I've been very insecure about losing weight. And I associate that with dating as well, because I'm like, I don't think I'm comfortable in my size to date. And I'm worried when I'm like, I mean, I am comfortable in my size to date. Let me say it like that. But I feel like I'm worried how the, I'm worried about how would I be seen. And then at the same time, it's like how I see myself a little bit, you know? It's just like, oh, I mean, I'm so comfortable in my body, but I still like, worried about that. So it was like, oh wow, it's very interesting to see how like I'm a very secure person. I'm not insecure at all, you know. But ding, it went in my head, you're not perfect. We all have little insecurity that like worries us. And me, it's not my skin complexion. Me, it's not my hair. It is none of that. Like, but my size is one of my very touchy subject. I hate when people bring it up and I'm like, well, here we go talking about me. How big I am, how this I am, how that I am, and stuff like that. And I would have never thought that's the reason why I'm so like guarded when it comes to love, when it comes to a lot of things in my life, but obviously it is. And in, at that moment, I was like worried about my size, you know, but it's just like, whoa, it's pretty true. Like, I've been on like eating better so I can lose weight, and then I stop and I'm like, why do I always feel like there's a reason stopping me from fully losing the weight that I want? Because there's a certain size I truly want to be. But it's like, I can never go through with the plan, never go through with my, like, I make plan, I make eating, like, everything. It just never, go. I never, like, literally never go through with it. And it's like, really bothered, it always bothered me. I mean, I feel like it's because of what I've allowed society to tell me what's beautiful. Like, you know how we glorify those women on TV and stuff like that. We're just now getting more curvy women to be, like, the lead actress on TV. It was a bit, like, a few, you know? Melissa McCarthy, Queen Latifah, Monique, Countess Vaughn, Raven Simone. Those are the ones I grew up with, literally. I can't remember who else was like a big woman on TV as a lead actress, like, you know, Loretta Devine, but I still feel like then she wasn't really like curvy, like, she's like a little bit thick, but it's just like, we don't have those big women representing us on TV as much, like, when I was growing up, you know, like, when I was 10, and it's like, I was like, oh, why don't you be this size, why don't you become this size, oh, you eat a lot, you do this, you do that, and it become like, such a big thing in my life, and that people don't realize like how like words can affect each like us. And you know, listen, we can't win everybody, you know, we gotta win some, lose some, but we can't let that stopping us from having the things that we want. I truly feel like I want to say this. I'm not a lovey-dovey type of girl. Like, I'm not all in this. I'm in love. I need to talk to my man all the time. Like I really can't do it. I go up and down. Even if I'm with you, you're not going to hear from me every day. But, I mean, I'm not saying you're going to not hear from me for a month. But you get the shush. But at the same time, I don't want that to stop me from living my best relation with somebody because of my weight, because of my size. And we gotta work on it, like, as society. I don't know what is yours that's stopping you from being with somebody. Mine is my weight that have stopped me for years to be with people, like, with somebody fully. I mean, I don't want to say fully, but maybe that hasn't allowed me to be myself fully, like, fully myself. Like, I was thinking back before I made this video, like, I like to wear bikini, like, not bikinis, what? Who wear bikinis in my size? Nobody, Sergine. But, you see, I like to wear, like, bathing suit, but if I'm with somebody, I don't, I don't know if I say, oh, let's go to the beach, let's do this, let's do that. I'm like, no, bro, we can do other things. Like, but I'm with my girls. I'm like, hey, guys, let's go to the pool. I'll wear my, like, the sexiest bikini I can find for curvy girls or slash plus size, whatever. And I'll take the best pictures. And sometimes I post them, sometimes I don't. But I do have, like, I think 3 on my social media. Sorry, Taina. She told me not to post it. She's my big cousin, my dad's side. But I'm sorry I posted them. But I wouldn't feel comfortable if I was with my man, like, in a bikini, in a whatever bathing suit, like, showing my body fully. Like, it's just, like, those things, like, really freaks me out. I mean, even if I do, but it's, like, my little insecurities. Like, it's just, like, are you seeing me for me, or are you just, like, I don't know. I don't know how to explain that. So I've told my roommates I really want to lose the weight, but just worried about when I lose it, if people want to be like, oh my God, can I have your number now? Like, people that, you know, that always see me, they're going to, like, see me so different. Because guess what? She's no longer a size 18, 16. First of all, I'm not. I don't even want to say my size. But, you know, and I've lost a lot of weight over the years, like past 3 to 2 years, because I wanted to. But at the same time, I'm not where I dream to be. But it's just, what if? You know? And I don't know. It's weird talking to a camera about my insecurities. And that is really my biggest one. Like, I don't have any others. Like, I was telling my friends, I'm like, when we go out and you see, like, all the guys talking to, like, the skinny girls, like, the less voluptuous girls. Maybe it's my personality because I'm very close off. When I see people, I just have, like, this frown in my face. But it's just sometimes it can be like, oh, we all look good. But why is, like, they always like, oh, I want this girl. You know, like, I don't know. I've heard my guy friends said it. Like, I'm not crazy. But then I always look back at them. Some of them I go back and forth. But some of them are just like, whatever, it's your preference. But sometimes I wonder, I'm like, why do you directly say I prefer? I mean, you can, it can be your preference, but it's just how they say it. Oh, like, I like skinny girls. Like, you know, I'm like, but why do you have to say skinny girls? What do you have to say? Big girl, fat girls, whatever. And, you know, people have a way to be very negative about people that are bigger. And I'm like, they always say, oh, why don't you lose weight? Why don't you do this? Sometimes people don't say it out of concern. That's my issue with people. They're like, oh, you're so insecure. Like, you're so sensitive about your size. No, heifer. I'm not insensitive about my size. I think you're being rude. I think you're being this. You're being, like, they just don't get it. People just bring it up. And sometimes, I feel like maybe because sometimes I hear my guy friends talking about my size. So that makes me see, like, view all the men the same way. Like, it's just like, oh, no, I don't want you to close to me. I don't want to be with you. Even, you know, even we are in the relationship with them. Like, there's always something that's stopping us from being, like, oh, like, fully ourselves. Like, you know, there's little things we want to be, like, oh, well, don't do this, like, because, you know, like, but is it okay? But, and I feel like because that's how I feel, I reflect it on others, and I don't give people their chance to, like, I don't know, maybe they wouldn't think that way. So, you know, I would hope they want it that way. Well, why do we know? Human beings are really weird. But I came up here to really say it out loud. I'm gonna work on bettering myself when it comes to me accepting my size. And, you know, I was even telling my roommates, Misha and Liza, how, like, since I've become pre-diabetic, I was diagnosed pre-diabetic or whatever. I know I have to lose weight, but regardless, I could have still, like, be a size zero and got, like, become diabetic, because half of my family are diabetic and some of them are skinny as hell. You know, so it's like a hereditaire. I don't know how to pronounce it in English, so I'm gonna keep it like that, okay? It's something that you can catch from, like, you know, it's whatever. I don't know. You got the words. I'm gonna type it down there. But no, I'm just saying, it's just like, you know, and I wanna lose the weight because me, it's actually like my doctor want me to eat better and lose the weight, some weight. And I told him, I was like, yeah, fine, whatever, I'll do it. I have been working toward it, but I just don't know if I'm okay with losing my weight. Or maybe I'm using my weight as like my security blanket. Who knows? But I want you to celebrate your insecurities because they are a part of making you of who you are, the person that you are, the beautiful, amazing person that you are inside and out. And our insecurities help us become stronger, I think. They make us better because then if you know, you can work on it. I don't want to sit here and pretend like, oh my God, I don't care about things or certain things doesn't affect me. But in the end, they do. We all have certain things that really bother us to an extent, to like where it's like an issue. I have people say, oh, you're so secure like with who you are. I'm like, yeah, I am. Whatever. I'm not a size 5 or... Is 5 a size? Yes. Like a size 4 or 2, but I'm happy with who I am. But at the same time, it is also an insecurity of mine, my weight. It is. And I want to challenge myself to work on it so it doesn't affect whoever I have in my life right now. Or, like, you know, the future or whatnot. Whether I'm single or not, it's not for people to know. And JK, but I'm just saying, I'm gonna do better. I'm not gonna be like my insecurity be a reflection of in my relationship and like ruin whatever I'm building with somebody because I think it's unfair and I think I'm amazing. Any guy that says things negative or anybody that say negative or something negative about you because of your size, your hair, your eyes, or whatever it is, flip them the birds. And say, you know what? I'm freaking amazing the way I am, okay? If it's not for health reasons somebody's telling you something, tell them to fuck off. First of all, my mom's gonna be upset that I cursed, but I'm just saying. Tell them fuck off. Because you know what? It is who I am, and that's it. And that's about it. So I thought I should talk about it because I don't know who's going through something similar as I am and stuff like that. I hope like I made enough sense for you guys and you, my beautiful ladybugs, can remember to always be yourself, love yourself enough and always love yourself so it can never reflect on whoever you're loving at the same time. Like your insecurity doesn't become a part of that relationship and destroy it. Me. It is my size. And I think whether I lose weight or stay the same, I'm still going to be amazing. And nothing's going to change. Probably people are probably not going to ask me for my number because, you know, I mean, people do. I don't want you guys to think I'm crying for attention. It's not that. It's just like, it's just how society has made me feel for so long and how I allow it to like become a part of me and make me worried about. Love is such a beautiful thing. Not. I mean, shoot, I don't believe in love, but you know, being with somebody is such a beautiful thing where you're like, you're happy, you share your little whatever with them. It's just like this harmony that you guys have, this, you know? So I don't want anything to make me miss out on that. And I feel like my parents did a really good job at making sure that I love myself. I feel secure in myself and stuff like that. But at the same time, you know, it does affect you when other people say things. This is why I think kids shouldn't have social media anyway. Grown-ups, and there's enough bullies out there. They don't need to go on social media to hear people say, oh, you're too fat or whatever. And listen, we can be... And also, I'm tired of you niggas seeing us as just... the girl, the your homie. Okay, we can be more than the homies as well. You see, I'm telling you, this have been my experience so far. But also, I know I have to work on myself and make sure like I remember that is my size is not an issue. My size is not the reason why I shouldn't be loved or love somebody or let somebody in my life. Because come on, girl. Shouldn't be, never allowed that to be. And I'm not perfect. It's gonna take some time, so it's not like I can like boom and it's like, ooh, I no longer feel like that anymore. But it's a work in progress, and I'm willing to do the work, to be honest. I'm willing to do the work. I'm willing to be less guarded, like my roommate said, like, just put the wall down. And all the way down. But me, it's put the wall up to here and stuff like that, and just let somebody love me. Okay? While I'm thick and all. And yeah, I do love myself, that's for sure. But, you know, that is my insecurity. Yours might be something else. Like I said, it just because you have insecurity doesn't mean, like, you're not a secure person. We all do. We all have insecurity about ourselves. Don't let nobody come around and fool you with this, oh, you're insecure because you're dark. No, heffa. Nobody cares about that. I mean, I don't know. I don't. Or, like, you this and that. No, that doesn't make you, like, just insecure overall. It makes you human that you have insecure. Like, listen, none of us are perfect. Kim Kardashian is not perfect, since you guys looked up to them a lot. Like, Beyonce is not perfect, you know. All of them are not perfect. And, listen, we've watched, like, Khloé's, like, the girl I looked up to because she was, like, a bit, you know, not the come side. She still is ish, I guess. But, you know, it's just like you watch her struggle with her weight and the reason why she wouldn't want to lose weight and stuff like that. So it's just like you're not alone in this fight. But when you do decide to change or work on your insecurities, do it for yourself. Like, I promise myself, I'm going to love myself a little bit more just so I can nurture those insecurities and don't let them take over my life or what I want to do or be, like, whatever it is, and just, you know, just work on them. And next time I'm in here, I will let you guys how that works, how is that working out for me. But honestly, I'm really grateful that my roommates brought up the love thing. I mean, nobody ever told me like that, like, bluntly. But having them saying it opened my eyes way more, and like little things people used to tell me that I need to work on and stuff like that. And we all worthy to love, whether you 300 pound, 100 pound, I don't know, whatever size you are worthy to be loved. Don't let that stop you from having the best thing that could be for you or me, is just having like a nice relationship where we're all happy, we argue and, like, you know, we make up and stuff like that. This is what I'm looking for. I don't wanna, it was the thing, I believe in love, 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 whatever. I've been in love twice, by the way. Do you see? I have. But, you know, I'm just looking for happiness, nothing else. That's about it when it comes to love. But I'm just saying in general, you know. Anyway, thank you for listening till the end or watching until the end. And just a reminder, you're awesome. I am awesome. We all are awesome. We all are awesome with our insecurities, the things we love about us. That's what makes us us. You know, the little things we don't like, the things we love, and that little insecurity we have about ourselves make us us. So remember that. You are amazing. You are a work in progress. You don't gotta be perfect. You don't care about what society says. As long as you're okay, deep down, don't ever let anybody make you feel any different. You know what? I just want to be like Lizzo. I'm pretty sure she has some insecurities about herself. But just, I want to be able to be in her category to the point where I celebrate myself, but I care without hearing what people have to say about, oh, your stomach is too big, do this, do that. You know, those little things that really sometimes can be hurtful without people knowing. But just be who you are, love who you are, and whether you're in a relationship with a man, with a woman, with whoever you are with, don't let your insecurity destroy that relationship, or don't let that person's insecurity destroy that relationship, you know. And don't let anything negative reflect on it. So that's about it. Keep on loving yourself, ladybugs. Keep on loving yourself. Keep on being proud of who you are and just nurture who you are, yourself, your body, your mind, your soul. So thank you for watching. And you already know the drill. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. And let me know what would you like to see more and on the YouTube channel. And we can work on it. Anyway, gotta go. And, oh, the most important thing I forgot. Wash your hands, your face. Be more careful nowadays with when you go out, what you like, how you come back home and do that. Please, guys, wash your hands as much as you can every day. Don't just do it once or twice a day. Do it more, given the circumstance of this, of the world, not the country, the world. And find things to keep you positive. You're allowed to break down every once in a while, but who's up? XOXO.
Believe everything that she makes up. It's more to it, lies underneath that makeup. Ooh, been like, how you know? Cause I'm the one that she be lying exposed. Sorry, my nose. She be at my crib with no blouse. Hate that this the way that you found out. But she made it spill like a water spout. When she looked me dead in my face and said, happy anniversary, baby. I felt that shit in my bones.
Something right.
So I went through her phone
just to double check.
Saw what you two had going on. Come to find out that bitch has been lying.
Lying like a dog.
Ooh, bitch, who you been lying to? You lying to me.
Bitch, who you been hiding?
I know where she hide at.
Say the truth, you been hiding.
I should've known what she's trying to do. Don't you believe everything that she makes up? Oh. More to it, lies underneath that makeup. Can't believe she been lying.
I don't know.
Sergine back in action. I want to say shout out to all of my health workers from now on until this whole thing is over. We're gonna keep honoring the health bitch. This is not it.
Some moon, you can remember.
People die.